even through the warring and the rain as it pours in. When I'm gone, will you remember this? Come fly away somewhere. Been here for days wanting, but nothing has changed for you. And you're tired and you don't want to live like this.
Man, I have missed you. This is something special going on right now, let me tell you.
Of course.
I'm so pleased to have you back, and I'm sure I'm not the only one. And you had me, well, I think you had everyone at, I need sunshine,
I need...
And which came from your platinum-selling album, Lonely Are the Brave.
Yeah.
And now you're hitting us back with another album, Innerstanding.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You are a folk, soul, hip-hop, reggae genius who's really built himself in the UK as an admirable, unique, and just pretty fab person. I mean, you are Maverick Sabre.
I am, yes.
Woo!
I love the positivity, Jesus.
I know people say I need to calm down. I'm trying.
No, tell them, no, don't listen to no one. You do you.
Well, thank you so much for being here. I'm so excited
me.
Because I absolutely love you.
Thank you.
This is just going to be so exciting.
Okay.
So let's get straight into it. You have a lot of power, literally. Like, you always deliver a powerful performance. Always, always, always. Please tell me, where does this force come from? Because there's a fan. What did he say? He said, he can power a nuclear station with his voice. I love this.
Right.
But seriously, where'd you get that engine from? Because your style is power. Not such a bad style to have, no?
No. I don't know. I suppose I think as musicians, anyway, for me, myself, it comes from somewhere that you don't quite understand. And I think that's the beauty behind it, and that's the blessing behind it. And all we're here to do is carry it
in the way
it should be carried.
And take it to the people.
Yeah, of course.
Well, I think what people think is you do have a kind of raw emotional energy, which you have, and you just make London look amazing. So let's just bring it back and see where it all began for you.
Okay.
So how did you first get into music? Because I know you were born in London, then you went over to Ireland, and then you came back. So tell me where it all began for you.
I suppose it was in Ireland when I was about maybe 7 or 8. My father's been in bands growing up my whole life.
Mm-hmm.
Never full-time, but always been in bands. Blues bands, rock bands, folk bands, everything. And I'd always been brought up around music and a lot of live music in my house. And that's where it really started, to be honest. I used to play and just kind of bang around on instruments when my dad and his friends used to come around. And then I started writing my own songs when I was about 8 or 9 and got into the Irish hip-hop scene when I was 14. And then that's where everything kick-started really from there, and I really started to, you know, form songs that had a meaning and a message behind it and express myself properly, and it all started off from there, really.
Well, I want to get into the mindset of you just before you came back to London.
Okay.
Was there anyone that stood out to you that kind of, like, pushed you to pursue music and come back to London and, you know, really give it a go?
My dad was a big supporter at the time.
I'm sure.
Was a big supporter. and my girlfriend at the time was another big supporter of me. And there was, you know, one or two friends that were quite supportive of me. And obviously, I'd built myself up in the scene as well. So there was, I'd had a little bit of support from, you know, the Irish hip-hop scene as well, which was always a beautiful thing.
I think you put Irish hip-hop on the map, because before you, I didn't really, you know, the two mixing, I didn't really know much about it. So,
oh, well,
I
that's, think if, you that's, are, if that's so, that's a beautiful
for me thing, anyway.
There's a beautiful wealth of hip-hop music in Ireland that I was inspired by and that helped me make music, you know, the Scary Eras,
amazing.
Lunatic, Urban Intelligence. And yeah, then I came over to London, and I suppose Plan B was probably the first person that gave me a bit of a, you know, an inspirational push when I came over here, and just kind of gave me a nudge to say, you know, follow what your passion is.
Okay, that's fab. Oh, cool. Plan B, everyone, like that. So I think it's safe to say you never let us down. When you put out music, you don't just put out music to put out music. Your music is always meaningful, which is why we love you. So I want to know, from your last album, which is Lonely Are the Brave, and now you're putting out your new album, Innerstanding.
Yeah.
What have you been up to during this time? It's been 3 years since you put the last album. Now, I want to know, what's been going on, man? What have you been up to?
Growing up, to be honest with you. Yeah,
okay.
Growing up, maturing, traveling and experiencing more about myself and more about the world, and trying to become, you know, a better person and a better artist, and yeah, and fine tune myself.
How have you made this album even better than your last? Because that one, like, everyone was going crazy for your last album. So how do you think it compares?
It's a different record. It's about different experiences. It's a different take on myself and the world than I had on the first. I've grown up, I see things differently.
Okay.
A lot differently than I did writing my first record. And it's a more, for me, it's a more vulnerable record and a more honest record.
Excellent. Because actually, all over social media, everyone is going crazy saying, yay, you're back, yay, you're back. Especially me, I'm doing the Teehee dance, like, yay, Maverick Sabre. So, as you said, your new single, Come Fly Away, is a long time coming. So let's talk about the new single now. Yeah. It's uplifting, it's powerful, it's all about change. Tell me, what kind of story were you trying to put out with this new single?
It was a story of two halves, really, to be honest. The first half of the song was a reflection of my own life and looking in and thinking, you know, and feeling at the time. It was a low period writing that song, and feeling that I needed to have a lot of change within myself and needing escapism, an overall need for change, really. And the second verse in the tune is my view on society and the world around me, and how just as much that needed a change as well. And, you know, just feeling there was a need for everyone to escape, in a sense, to something better, and a change for something better, and that, you know, there is something better than the way we live and the way we perceive the world.
No, because it is very uplifting, exactly.
Great.
I like that.
Great.
Well, let's talk about the writing process now, because how does it all come to you? Do you have like a go-to pair of slippers that you have to wear when you're writing, or a certain tea or alcoholic beverage maybe that you've got to go to when you're writing? How does it all happen?
No, you just got to feel. You just got to feel.
Because the music's based on real events, isn't it?
Yeah, I've got to feel if I have an argument with someone or a discussion with someone about a certain topic that I feel needs to be discussed,
you're
and it's on my
pen.
Mind. Yeah, if I'm depressed and if I'm down and if I don't know what to do in my life, I don't know where to go, I don't know who I am, I don't know what I'm doing, I write. If I'm in love, I write. If I'm angry, I write. Mm-hmm. I write when I feel, you know.
Okay.
I write when there's a strong emotion in me. You know, so that's where the music comes from.
I like that. And so your new album, Innerstanding, which is out on the 30th of October, people. What does Innerstanding mean? What does the title mean?
Innerstanding means looking within to change, rather than looking for something else to change you.
Mm-hmm.
We always, and what we, especially, you know, young people right now, our generation, have been brought up to look outwardly for happiness,
mm-hmm.
you know, whether it's in money or whether it's in, you know, a sexual partner, or whether it's in just, you know, having someone else to validate you as a human being or you as a loving person. We always look outwardly rather than looking within to actually change. And that's what the last 3 years has been for me. That's what I'm still going through now, and that's what this record reflects.
Okay. And on the album, you've teamed up with a lot of people.
Mm.
You've teamed up with Joey Badass. Mm. You've got a deluxe mix with Idris Elba, Gorgon City, Crux.
Yeah.
This is, tell me about the theme of the album now, because that's a whole bunch of people with lots of different genres. What is there a theme?
Yeah, well, there's a deluxe version and there's the original version. The original version's got 13 tunes on it, and the only features on that are Joey and Crux.
Okay.
And the reason is only Joey and Crux, because they fit in exactly to, you know, what I represent within my music. And they sit beside my message, they sit beside my sentiment and me as a person. And I've become quite closer to two of them in the last 3 years, you know, so they've been a big vital part of everything. And a vital part of me keeping faith within musicians that there are actually other musicians out there that want to do something, you know, positive. And yeah, on the deluxe version, we've got Gorgon City collaborations, Idris collaborations, Zane Lowe collaborations, Soul Sorkin.
I'm so excited for this album, oh my gosh.
No, good, yeah. And they're just, you know, my favourite bits of music that I've done over the last 3 years as well. So you get I think with the deluxe and the original together, you get a real sense of me in the last little period of my life, you know.
Well, out of all your tracks and all the music you've put out, you okay there? All the tracks that you put out, including your new album, what would you say is your favorite one then?
Favorite tune that you've put out.
It doesn't have to be your single, just anything that you have a real connection with. Obviously all your music, but your best one.
Everything's got so many different so many different meanings to it. I think the one, just that's off the top of my head, not my favourite or anything, but one that really stands out for me is Shooting the Stars that I wrote on my first album.
Okay, yeah.
Just because of what I was inspired by, I'd read about this case about a young Oscar Grant, who's a young black guy in, I think it was in Oakland, who got pulled off a train on New Year's Eve and basically got executed by police on the kind of waiting area beside where this rail, not underground, it was an overgrown rail station was, and he got executed on camera in front of loads of people that were going out partying that night. And it was something, I was back home in Ireland when I read this, and it just kind of it triggered off a train of thought in my mind, and I started looking into just, you know, a lot of cases in America, police killings and the injustice behind no one actually getting taken up for it and charged with anything, and it inspired just I just felt like something needed to be written about that, for me anyway. I researched just a lot of different things and, you know, delved into my own life and wrote a story around that and then reflected on that within it, you know, because I felt like it needed to be written about, so.
No, you talk about a lot of real things, real issues. This is why you're a good artist.
Thank you.
Literally. Okay, fab. And I also want to talk about November, because you have a very busy month ahead of you, because you're going on tour for your new album. Is that right?
Yeah.
Tell me, what can we expect from a Maverick show then? What do we have to look forward to?
Soul and you know, all I'm not here to offer you flashiness and to offer you
here to keep it real.
Yeah, well, I'm not here to offer you some mad flashy guest performances all the time. I'm not gonna come out in sparkles and your new favorite designer suit or anything like that. I'm here as a musician to give you music and to speak for you. That's what I write my music for, and I will always do, even if there's 10,000 people in the crowd or one person in the crowd. That's what I'm here to do, you know. So yeah, I'm gonna offer you every bit of my heart and my soul. That's what I'm going to offer you.
Excellent. Well, Mav, you love to hit us with amazing tune after amazing tune after amazing tune. But the thing is, because we're so sucked into your amazingness, we maybe don't get to know who the real Maverick is.
Right.
So literally, because your music is so powerful and tense, right, but you're actually a fun guy.
Oh, yeah, of course.
Reminds me of a joke. Have you heard of this mushroom joke? Okay. What do you call a mushroom that likes to party?
I don't know, I don't have a clue.
A fun guy?
Get it? The jokes are getting worse and worse here. What's going on?
It's a joke that just came to my head.
Oh, it just came to my head.
Moving on.
Freestyling, continue. That's great.
Your new single is called Come Fly Away.
Right.
So, if you could choose any place in the world, where would you like to fly away to?
Right now, Antigua.
Okay. Antigua. When you're busy flying away, who is it that you would like to take with you? Someone that you know, like a pet or a friend?
I don't have a pet. I don't know, I suppose a beautiful woman that's intellectual, so we could lie on the beach, have conversations and have fun.
Doesn't sound too bad. If you were a superhero, would you prefer to fly or be invisible?
I think probably being able to fly, you could achieve more with it, so, yeah.
Okay. And which artist would you want to come and fly away with you? So they'll be singing their songs the whole way during flight mode. Which song?
If I could bring back Otis Redding.
Okay,
I'd have
cool.
Otis and I'd just be singing with him the whole way there, so, yeah.
So is there a certain lady you would like to take away with you?
No one specifically.
You can say me if you want, I don't mind.
Well, if you're on offer, as long as you just don't tell any of them rubbish jokes, you'll be alright, because you'll be getting kicked straight
I'll
off.
I'll try not to, I'll try
and
keep it
I'll be bringing my guitar along and saying, look, if you can keep the jokes quiet, then yeah, alright,
okay,
no problem.
I'll try my best.
There's a space for you.
And lastly, when you're busy flying away, what is the one snack you need to be taking with you? I call it a Sabre snack, not a Scooby snack. Sabre snack.
Right,
what's your Sabre snack?
Avocado. It's got to be avocado.
Oh my gosh, I'm a big avocado fan.
All right, wicked.
Okay, so you're putting out your album, you've got all your tour dates lined up, and you have your new single, Come Fly Away, which is out now.
Yeah.
Can this officially be the moment we get excited?
Of course, get excited.
High five me, bro.
That's
go.
Wicked. That's
wicked.
It. That's
so the album, Innerstanding, is dropping on the 30th of October.
Yeah.
So Halloween is not bringing us a trick this year. Instead, it's bringing us a treat. And it is Maverick Sabre's new album, Innerstanding.
Exactly. That's a lovely album.
Beautiful. Wicked. So to wrap it up, how do you feel about putting out new music then?
Yeah, excited. I just want to get it out at this stage, you know, and I want people to hear it. So yeah, excited, definitely.
I'm excited too. Wicked. Maybe you could tell, I don't know.
Wicked, of course.
So tell everyone where we can find you on social media.
Social media, Maverick Sabre Twitter, Maverick Sabre Facebook, Maverick Sabre YouTube. It's all fairly simple. The soul is there, just needs to be connected to, that's all.
Excellent. Maverick, you truly personify the word artist. You are such a cool guy with such a unique voice, and I'm just so happy for you.
Thank you, and I'm happy
good luck
for you.
With all your album, your tour, and everything
you.
Else you got going,
you
because
much.
It's just going to be fabulous.
Thank you very much.
Bring on October the 30th.
Exactly. Woo!
I am Amika Ezer, and I'm coming to you from Media2Radio team, and I'm here with the amazing, incredible Maverick Sabre.
Love.
Woohoo!
Love.